great idea. Taking the radio show and putting it on television. Brilliant. Explosive television. Shocking television. This is genius.
That is something going on out in the hall. It's amazing.
Well, here's what happened. The spin doctors said they wanted to come in because we went to number one in Myrtle Beach, and they heard about Fred the Elephant Boy finally getting a girlfriend.
And they heard about Fred getting married.
Right, so they want to be
here. So many things to celebrate.
They're going to do their hits. They're going to do the new song. They're going to do a lot of things. So, needless to say, the spin doctors said, hey, we're going to bring in all our gear. Because usually we just have a band come in with...
They thought we had a big studio, I'm sure.
Yeah.
It's so big.
I tried to tell them, we'll plug you into the board, bring some electric guitars, I'll give you a drum kit. I'll give you like a hi-hat and a snare. And, you know, the lead singer's a good singer. Let him sing the song.
Now what happened?
Well, they said, listen, we're going to bring in all our gear. They want to bring in their gear. So we got
a
the drum.
Setup.
We have to set the drums up in the hall.
I can hardly get in there. There are so many wires running through the hall now.
It's not going to sound like the record anyway.
It's right in front of the door.
Yeah, I wanted to tell the guys, it sounds just as good when you plug through the board. It takes 2 seconds and we could be doing it already. But okay, I'm not going to tell the spin doctors what to do. Let them do their thing. All right, here's the spin doctors,
That's
everybody.
The dude right there.
Well, Chris, everyone knows you because you, of course, are the lead singer. The lead singer gets all the attention.
That's right.
Isn't that true?
Yeah, I meant it to be that way, actually.
And that's what's great about being the lead singer. And, of course, sitting next to you is Mark White.
Who is black.
Who is black. That is correct. That's right. I forgot there's a black guy in the spin
doctors.
Right. That's very cool. So the black guy's the bass player. It's always that way.
Black guys play bass.
Yeah, what is that about?
It's the rhythm thing.
Yeah, you're a good-looking guy.
Thanks. He's the best-looking guy in the band.
Yeah, he is. He's got a hot white chick out there, too. Everyone told me already, yeah. Right?
That's right.
Did you have white girls before you were in Spin Doctors, or did you always get white girls?
No, only after the Spin Doctors.
Really? Yeah. Once it started happening, then you get the whole white woman thing.
And,
cool.
Yeah, there's nothing you can do about it.
But you go both ways, right? You'll go with black women and white women.
Any women.
Really? Yeah. So seriously, before you guys hit big, I mean, you guys have been around for a while, but before you hit real big, it would only be like black girls, seriously?
No, before I was in the Spin Doctors at all.
Really?
Yeah.
You'd only had black women. Like
well,
you lost
people
your
I met at my job.
Right.
Yeah. What kind of job did you have?
The mailroom.
Oh.
Really? Well, you guys are real rock stars. It's true. You were in the mailroom, and you know, you're a good-looking guy, but meanwhile, the white women wouldn't notice because right away they're nervous—a black guy in a mailroom. And then, hey, where's your white? Where is that your girlfriend out there?
Yeah.
Oh, damn. Is she really hot?
Yeah.
Really?
Is she a model?
She a model?
No, she's not a model.
She's not.
She's very cute, very busty.
Hey, can we see her? You spin doctor's mind?
Okay.
Certainly not.
Oh. Cool. By the way, the whole band is here with us today, of course.
Did they all bring their girlfriends?
They don't all have girlfriends.
Black guys like to bring along their white girlfriends.
They're white girls.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's like the way, you know, they're high maintenance.
Yeah, I gotta show her around.
Show her around, bring her to the radio station. I understand where that's at. Let me see her. Yeah, she looks like a guy. Oh, that is a guy. I'm sorry.
That big guy right
That big guy is your girlfriend? That's unbelievable. You should just keep her in a trophy case, my friend. That's what I'm looking for. I gotta get myself a white girlfriend. Let me see her. Wow. Come on and just say hi. So you're Mark White's girlfriend, huh? Oh, yeah. Oh.
Fiancé, she just said.
Oh, fiancé. Yeah, sure.
Oh.
How many fiancés do you have right now?
Just one.
Really? Seriously? You're going to marry her?
Yeah.
Really? When are you getting married?
Make her sign a prenup.
Already got a date?
Prenup.
Yeah, we both got to do that, actually.
Yeah, you're going to do prenups?
Yeah, of course.
Oh, you're hot.
What's she protecting? He's got to sign one, too.
Yeah, now I know what Mark has to protect for his prenup. I mean, he's got spin doctor money, which is major cash.
Not really.
What are you protecting? Are you sitting on some kind of...
Motherload? That's a fair question. Well, yeah, my mother, more than me.
Oh, really? Your mother's very rich?
It is the motherload, actually.
It is the motherload. She's actually sitting on a motherload. Are you rich?
This is a power marriage.
Yes. Really? No kidding, because she's a millionaire.
What does your mother have? Who is your mother?
Who is your mother? What does she do?
She's Canadian.
Oh, Canadian. No wonder. They all have money up there.
It's more like an alliance.
Lots of land.
Hey, good for you, Mark. Smart move, Marianne.
A rich white girl.
A rich white
girl.
Well, you hit the jackpot.
This is too much.
Hey, let me say something to my homie.
You go, boy.
Mark's in the house. All right.
He knows how to do it.
Yeah. What do you mean? What did your mom do?
She used to be a university professor, and then she took over my dad's businesses.
Which were? Would your dad die or something?
Yes.
Those are the best girls to marry. They need a father image. Seriously, no offense. No offense, Spin
Doctor. I don't think he looked like her father.
He don't look like her father. Was your father black? No? Oh, he's a good-looking guy. I could see why you go for him. I'm kind of attracted. What is it, Baba Booey? What's the matter with you? All right, so anyway, so you say you met. The two of you fell in love. Obviously, you met in love. We fell in love. He was in the Spin Doctors. Who
Now, of course, you wouldn't have looked at him when he was a mailroom person.
No, that's not true, actually.
Oh, right. Where were you when he was in the mailroom? Sure. Where were you?
Where were you going to see him?
Now, let me ask you something, and you don't have to answer. Did your father die when he found out your fiancé was black? Was there a racial thing there? Because a lot of guys are still uptight about that. Not me, but a lot of guys.
No, before that. And my family's pretty good, so is his.
So your father was this big businessman?
Land developer, yeah.
Oh, I thought he invented... I thought he invented whiteout, like the guy from the monkeys, the Nesmith.
We just haven't slept much last night. I'm really pale now.
You haven't slept much because you two were making love, right? Oh, boy, I tell you something. I got to get in the rock and roll business.
That's a little late for you, Howard.
Yeah. Mark, you're a lucky man.
Thank you.
I hope I'm invited to the wedding. If people should be dancing to your music, am I correct?
Correct.
I am the Fred Astaire of disc jockeys. Oh, now I feel good. Robin, during this next number by the Spin Doctors, I will dance with Gay Rich and Jolynn, the professional stripper who really knows how to dance. Because people should be dancing to your music. Am I correct?
Correct.
I am the Fred Astaire of disc jockeys. You will see it on TV tonight. Now, all right, so now this selection...
I hope Mark's equipment is working.
Here we go. Now, I am going to turn off all of these mics.
All right.
Now, we should have the whole microphone problem worked out during this song.
I should hope.
And this is the new single, You Let Your Heart Go Too Fast. This is about people who jump into things too fast. You understand? All right, go ahead.
Hey.
I tell you, I was just dancing with Gay Rich during that. He moves his ass better than Joe Lynn. After that dance, I think I'm engaged to Gay Rich.
No comment.
No, well, this is about your stepmother, am I correct?
We're pulling all my dirty laundry out here.
Well, it's true, though, isn't it? Hey, what's the other hit song that I like? The
Pocket Full of Kryptonite.
Little Miss Can't
Old
Be Wrong.
Miss Can't Be Wrong.
Do you feel like are you guys sick of doing that one?
I got
or something?
Do a Pocket Full of Kryptonite.
No, I want to do Little Miss Can't Be Wrong.
I love Pocket Full of Kryptonite.
We'll do them
I'm
going to
give you a Pocket Full of Kryptonite next.
Shut up, you.
No, come on, wait a second. Do Little Miss Can't Be Wrong. Now this is about Chris's stepmother, who was a real dink, I guess. I don't know, right? You hated her guts, right?
Oh, I no comment.
Well, this is about your stepmother, am I correct?
We're pulling all my dirty laundry out here.
Well, it's true, though, isn't it?
I categorically deny it.
No, you do not deny it.
I deny it.
It is about your stepmother, isn't it? What
happened? Well, you keep talking, Howard. You tell me what happened.
Well, let me see this.
Because I'm going to keep denying it.
You were growing up what? You were an army brat?
Yeah.
So you were a real brat, in other words?
I was just a brat.
And what happened? Your old man, what happened? Your mom died or something?
No, she lives in Australia.
She abandoned you. What the hell is
funny
about
that?
You got
all my dirty laundry out here.
Did she actually abandon you?
No. They got divorced and she married an Australian guy. He's
and great. What happened to you? You didn't go with mom?
No, can you believe it?
No wonder you're growing that beard. You're all screwed up. I'm telling you, Chris. You got to go into therapy.
I grew up with my dad.
Did you go into therapy and stuff over there?
Oh, man, I've been to more therapy than
seriously?
Stick at.
Really?
But now I'm all fixed up.
No, he's really... is he really messed up or what?
Right, pretty cool.
No. Pretty cool?
Who's the craziest guy in the band, guys?
Aaron.
You're like a bearded orphan, Chris. Oh. I'm telling you, man. You're an orphan.
How does he wind up with his dad? I mean, was
Because his mom abandoned him. You should have written a bad song about your mom.
I ended up with my dad.
Huh?
I don't know. He's the more responsible of the two.
Really? Because your dads are never the ones who get custody. Seriously, you guys.
Right. I mean, it's just like...
Yeah, I know, it's
rare. Mom didn't even put in a bid, huh?
The rest of the band is like, oh, man, I didn't know any of this. I thought it was about some hot chick.
Really?
I thought the song was about a girl or something. Did you guys know that this was about Chris's stepmom?
No, we didn't know.
You really didn't know?
I deny it.
I don't think it's about his stepmom, though.
It is about his stepmom.
No, it isn't.
You mean you're in the band?
Where did
you
hear that, Howard? Where did you hear that?
I heard that. Where did I hear that?
We read it in Rolling Stone.
Right.
They didn't actually come out and say it, but it was.
See, but I denied it in Rolling Stone.
Right, but it was.
Yeah, well, you better cop to it here.
It was a weak denial.
Have you guys ever talked to Chris about it?
I categorically deny it.
Have you ever talked to Chris about it?
Oh, I cry on their shoulder all the time.
Boy, these guys are really quiet about it. Everyone's
they won't
tired.
Talk about Chris.
No comment.
No, you guys know the truth. You know what happened. This is about Chris. Now, what happened? So your stepmom used to beat you and stuff?
No, it wasn't so bad.
I mean, because when you think about it, the song is Little Miss Can't Be Wrong. In other words, no matter how many
everything
times...
Everything she says is right.
Right. Everything she says is right. Everything is right.
You know what the opening line of the song is?
Yeah, go ahead.
It's been a whole lot easier since the bitch left town.
Yeah? Oh, boy. That must have been fun. Do you ever...
throw darts in the picture?
You know, Chris, maybe you should smoke a joint, then I'll ask you to sing this song. It might be too painful.
It's too late, Howard. I already did.
No wonder you're all wasted. Seriously, Chris, it's a painful song for you to sing each time because it...
Each and every time, Howard. I shed a little tear.
The stepmother was rough on you?
I wasn't so bad.
Now that you're out
It all turned out fine, didn't it?
Do you still see her?
Okay, right?
Did she used to take your pot away and you became angry with her? No, but what was it? I mean, you would say to her, hey, look... Mom, I'm trying to be reasonable. Did you have to call her mom?
Yeah, isn't that crazy?
You had to call her mom, and of course, that upset you, and she would lay down the law to you and say, hey, look, you're not my
and
real
you're
mother.
Like, you're not my mom.
You're not my mom. You're just like, you're some lady who married my father. Right?
Right.
And then what happened? You had a big blowout, now you left home early at a young age?
19, is that young?
No. And then do you still
did
see her?
Did she leave or did you leave?
We both did.
I get it that the parents aren't together anymore.
You mean she hung around till you were 19 and then she left?
And then she split. Yeah.
Great. She couldn't split when you were young.
Exactly. She had to ruin my teenage years and then split.
What a great gal. Unbelievable. Well, no wonder you're angry when you say, where are the lyrics?
It's been a lot easier since the bitch left town.
Now I'm going to listen to this song with new ears.
See, you got to check out the lyrics.
Well, you know what? Wherever she is, you can go buy her house now and toss her out.
That's right. Raise the rent.
So does she try to contact you now that you're famous?
Her roof leaks.
Now that you're famous.
I don't want her house.
No, now that you're famous, does she try to contact you?
No, I don't even know if she knows.
Really?
You're kidding.
Wow, that's really unbelievable.
I tell her.
Here's the lyric.
Don't you want her to know?
No way.
Been a whole lot easier since the bitch left town. Nobody upstairs gonna stomp and shout. Nobody at the back door gonna throw my laundry out.
Ooh,
so
man.
In fact, she did throw your laundry out.
Well, yeah.
She holds the shotgun while you do-say-do.
Do-si-do.
I never knew how to spell that. So.
Let's see. Little Miss can't be wrong. Ain't nobody gonna bow no more when you sound your gong. Oh, she really had you stepping to it. Did she ever beat you?
She thought you were in the Army.
No.
But she beat you mentally, you're saying?
Well, yeah.
Okay. Oh, great. Well, now I'm ready to dance. Now I'm ready to party to your problems. You know, out of all great problems comes great work. Here's one last one from the Spin Doctors.
One, two.
Here's one last one from the Spin Doctors, celebrating our number one status in Myrtle Beach, Robin.
It's a concert.
Where are the dancers?
Bring on the dancing girls. Bring on the dancing girls.
Nobody at the back, I'll keep throwing my lonely eyes. She only
guys are going to be great.
It's a unique, different show. We like to call it Newsweasels because that's basically what these guys look like. Two guys stage a coup and wind up having their own show. It's confusing, but watch it. You'll understand.